This is Justin Germino, and I'm going over some of the features of the Snoppa ATOM 3-axis gimbal. This basically allows you to take professional camera video and shots from your phone because the gimbal holds the camera perfectly steady so that if you need to move around the subject, like I'm using my dog as the subject here, the gimbal holds the camera perfectly steady so you don't see any movement, you don't get shaky cam and things like that. So going over some of the features of the gimbal, I'll show you in the Snoppa ATOM gimbal here. You have your thumbstick right here, which is used to adjust your point and click, so it goes up and down or left and right. It's a thumbstick to adjust for micro adjustments here. You've got your menu button up here, which you press with your thumb as well, and you can choose between the various shots in the Snoppa app, as well as whether or not you want to do video, and it also acts as the select button. Then you have the thumb button down here, which is the actual snapshot button for taking pictures or starting and stopping the recording. Over off to the side here, accessible by your thumb barely, it's a little difficult, is your zoom button. This allows you to zoom your camera in and out. It's a little hard to reach. You have to kind of twist the grip a little bit. I think the zoom button could have been a little easier. You've got your mic jack if you want to plug in a microphone and actually use your voice on a mic on the Snoppa. Right now I'm using the mic on the separate camera that you're seeing to record this, but if I wanted to use the mic from the phone, I could plug it into this Snoppa jack here. Then, of course, you've got the rear trigger, which you can customize to do what you want with. So, as you can see, and again, using my dog as the test subject here, you could see I can get in really close. I could do movement adjustments. You see the phone stays relatively steady during the shots. This 3-axis gimbal camera holder will actually fold and be very compact. One thing I did notice, though, is if you need to slide it to portrait mode, you can simply adjust it, and then you could see how the Snoppa ATOM will adjust and know you're in portrait mode and keep you in portrait mode. Although I have noticed that sometimes it gets a tad out of sync and you've got to resync it. It tends to want to focus on a specific object, and so you have to occasionally tap your screen and make it point at the center object. If you were just to point at nothing or background scenery, I noticed sometimes it could lose the direction as to what you're trying to point to and what you're trying to focus at, and I've had it lose control over focusing on the point that I want to focus at. So that's one thing I did notice. That's probably just a firmware update. And sometimes when it goes out of sync like this, I did have to power it off and power it on again to let it go back into sync itself, back to Bluetooth connection sync mode so it could sync on the object. So, but that didn't happen very often, and generally it's really good for taking pictures like this. Now, if you use a case for your cell phone, again, the case might be too thick for it to fit in these jaws, and that's something I did report to the company. So you tend to want to have either a slim case or no case on your phone if you put your phone in the gimbal. You can use the front-facing camera or the rear-facing camera with it, of course, by switching the app as well. And you could see if I lock right here, you could do pivot locks on the device itself. Let me lock it. That way it will not spin. It stays in one mode. But I'll show you the back of it, how the camera is accessible right here on the back. Your USB charging's right here. Another feature of the ATOM gimbal I wanted to show you is the fact that it comes with a charging cable, so that not only does it charge via USB Type-C, but it comes with a Lightning to USB Type-C charger, so the ATOM gimbal can actually charge your phone while you're using it and keep your phone charged so you don't run out of battery. So that's another good feature as well. Also, this thumb button right here with an M on it acts as the manual portrait or landscape mode switch. So instead of adjusting it manually, you could just press the button and it'll adjust to portrait or landscaping mode as well. Although, if you're going to leave it plugged in, you might want to make sure the cord doesn't get caught when it switches modes, but that is another option as well. Again, this is the Snoppa ATOM 3-axis gimbal for phones. It allows you to take precise shots and moving shots with your phone without worrying about the jitters and the shaking cam. And it takes some getting used to. There's a lot of learning involved. I noticed that it's definitely not, it's not something you can just pick up and run with and get perfect at. You have to experiment with it. You have to practice with it. So I'm still getting used to it myself, but overall I really like using it. And it helps for getting for much smoother shots than me trying to hold the camera with my hand. Thank you for watching.